it's hidden, but it's hidden in the same way that you know, when the Earth passes between the rays of the sun and the moon is eclipsed. It's occluded. So, I mean, you could take out any, you know, book on, you know, history of theosophy, and you can read, or any biography of Annie Besant, and you'll find this out about her. Just like you can find out about someone like a fellow named Julius Evola, who was an Italian occultist and esotericist in the 20s, 30s, and 40s, who wrote books about a variety of different esoteric ideas, and he tried to influence first Mussolini and then Hitler. And he had certain ideas about a spiritual kind of elite and a spiritual aristocracy and how society should be based on that and so on and so on. So he's out in the open. I mean, these things are there. I mean the sense out in the open is if you do the research,
Well, you know, I'm pretty well versed in people like Manly P. Hall that have written about this, Nicholas Roerich. They are definitely out in the open, but I find more often than not, those involved in the modern occult are not so. I want to get into what you think their end game is after this. It's the Alex Jones Show. We are back. It's the Alex Jones Show. I am Jason Burmis sitting in. The websites are Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.tv. Our guest is Gary Lachman. He's the author of Politics and the Occult, The Right, The Left, and The Radically Unseen. I guess I want to ask you, Gary, you keep talking about a progressive elite that are into the occult. If they get their way, what does the world look like? What are they working towards?
Well, there isn't a they. It's not like there's one group. It's I give a variety of different examples of a more left-oriented or progressive interest in the occult that was, you know, linked up with politics. And I gave you one there, Annie Besant, who was...
Yeah, but in the beginning you said...
Let me answer your question.
Sure.
I gave you one, Annie Besant, who was involved in Indian independence. It's a historical book. It's about history. I start in the 1600s. I go up to, you know, just sort of... I mean, the last people I talk about are the Christian fundamentalists involved in the Left Behind series of books in the States that are big, you know, bestsellers and all that. But, you know, if you look at something like early 20th century England, where I just talked about the Fabians, you had a whole, just before World War One, you had a whole slew of sort of ideas that would later become, you know, rediscovered in the 1960s, which when everybody thinks, you know, mysticism and yoga and, you know, a variety of different kind of occult or esoteric practices were discovered. I mean, people were doing those in the 19th century. They were doing them in the early 20th century. But when they were doing the early 20th century, especially here in England, you know, where I'm living now, they were associated with these very progressive ideas, like free love was one of them, white education, religious tolerance, social tolerance, a breakdown of the class system. But if you want to go to, those people involved in that, there wasn't like one group who had an agenda to go and, you know, sort of, you know, pursue in politics. But if you go earlier, say, in the late 18th century, which is sort of the heyday of Freemasonry, when, especially in Central Europe, in the German-speaking countries, you had, this is, you know, with the Illuminati come out of that time. It's got nothing to do with the film with Tom Hanks. Mm-hmm. You have famous people like Mozart, you have people like the German poet Goethe, and many other very influential thinkers and writers who were really involved in this Masonic notion of, again, of religious tolerance, racial tolerance, of sexual tolerance. They were that's when you started to have Masonic groups that allowed women in. They allowed Jews and Christians would sit side by side at these Masonic meetings. And there was an idea that if these ideas of the brotherhood of man and this kind of individual freedom and social tolerance were they to spread, there would be a new age in Europe. Now, unfortunately, what happened is a lot of those ideas got fed into a lot of the radical groups involved at the beginning of the French Revolution. And it went completely out the window. You know, it went from this fantastic dawn of a new age to, you know, to the terror when, you know, people were getting, you know, their heads chopped off left and right all over Paris. And all those hopes were dashed. This has turned into a nightmare. And then out of it, you get a new right-wing sort of Masonic sensibility coming up as a reaction to sort of, you know, the terror, as a reaction to the revolutionary sensibility. So I mean, if I wanted to pocket it in two different ways, I would say the progressive people that are, you know, that have brought esoteric ideas into politics, they want to, basically what they like to do is create the kind of, as I said, socially, religious, gender-tolerant society that we give a lot of mouth, you know, we give a lot of lip service to these days, you know, the pluralistic society.
We only have about 90 seconds left, Gary. In the beginning of the interview, you said that the left and the right seem to converge on this same idea. Is this the one that you're talking about?
No,
basically,
no. The left and the right, they come together because they both hate the modern world. Mm-hmm. They both find the modern world evil for different reasons.
But are they pushing for different things? As I'm asking.
From the right point of view, it's the complete loss of tradition. It's the leveling of society. It's the whole loss of any kind of hierarchy. It's mm-hmm. the loss of any kind of order of rank where mm-hmm. anything goes. You know, and from the left position, it's the rise of capitalism. It's the rise of laissez-faire. It's the rise of you know, basically every man out for himself, which, you know, and the duping of the masses through things like the culture industry and, you know, television and popular entertainment and all that sort of thing. So both of them, both sides.
Gary, let me just stop you just for a second. One last question. I mean, thank you for your time. Gary, are you an occultist?
No, I don't practice anything. I'm a historian and a philosopher.
Okay, thank you very much. The book is Politics and the Cult, The Right, the Left, and the Radically Unseen. It's the Alex Jones Show. We'll be back after this. I'm Jason Burmes, PrisonPlanet.tv, InfoWars.com.